Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Skyrim Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. That's Carlia behind me. We are in our final area in Skyrim. We have explored everything. So this is in Winterhold. It's called the Sightless Pit. We're about to go through this door and enter the Temple of Zrib. Whatever. So far we've encountered Farmer. Chorus and a couple frostbite spiders. So I wonder what this is. Temple of Zrib, and my frame rate is horrible right now. My apologies. 27 frames a second. Another Charis.
Who's there?
Warmonger. Ow. Did I hit you by mistake? I'm not sure. I don't know where my arrow went. Okay. Oh, silver ring, huh? I don't want that though. My arrow, 64 gold. Frostbite Venom. And Frostbite Venom. Have a seat. Yeah. Okay. Oh, there's one.
What was that?
There's another somewhere. Oh! Oh, we're gonna heal him. Sure do. So far, anyway. Use this stuff up, because we're probably going to get more venom from these guys at some point. More poison. See? Poison. 59 gold. Oh, I don't want a farmer arrow. I thought that was one of mine. Oh, we're stuck on this thing?
Lead on. Good.
What the hell? Alright, so I searched that one. This one. 24 gold. Oh, vampire dust he has. Interesting. Oh, there's the other one. 17 gold. They came out of here. I didn't see this hut. Okay. I have enough Charis eggs for a long time. 8 gold. One way up there. They move around like spiders, these things. Damn. Oh, I did not let that button go. Stay still for a sec. Oh, there's one right there. And a Charis. Shut up, you're gonna alert the other ones. Jump behind you, sweetie. Gold. Here's my arrow. Ooh, a staff of ice storms. That's an area effect thing, so I'm gonna give you this.
Please make it brief.
Nah. No brief. There you go.
Good.
It's my arrow. Oh, and a silver amethyst ring. Cool. Yeah, let's use another frostbite venom. Isn't it my bow that I have out? Yeah, it's poison. It's poison now. It's 2 of my ebony arrows back. 15 gold, and the mirror's rot. Okay. What's over here? Nothing? Not much. Four Daedric arrows. Was Carlyas or did this thing have it? 7 gold. Yeah, they were in him. Well, it must have been you using Daedric then. Guess you have more Daedric than I do. Flawless Emerald, 27 gold, extreme healing. Sorry, guys. Well, I am over a cold. It's just gunked. Potion of extreme. Where is it? Right, okay. Already favorited. I'm gonna continue on that way. Diamond, flawless ruby, 13 gold. Alright, that's it. You only have the one way up. This place is pretty big. Temple of Zrib. Stand by a sec, guys. Okay. Alright, we go up this way then. Does this take us around or out of here? So I do want to look all around here, too. Yeah.
Wait, I hear something.
It's a Charis now.
Shadows consume you.
Something like that. Shadow Master. With one hit. Wow. 30 gold. Another staff of ice storms.
What is it?
It's another staff of ice storms. Yeah. Not gonna be able to carry this stuff anymore. I need to find out who that is and return it to them. Whose that is.
Good.
Chest. Elixir of Two Shot, Flawless Emerald, Flawless Ruby, 3 gold. Now, I have a potion of True Shot favorited. Not elixir, so here we go. Continuing our tour here. I do want to look around the bottom level of this too. Hello? It's so funny, and like right in front of me, you can't see me. I'll use that poison.
Your life is forfeit!
Finish him.
Bless you.
There you go.
Shadows. I live another.
Another day, good job. 5 ebony arrows. I didn't use all that. 7 gold. Die. Another die. Oh, I see him. Almost out of frostbite venom, can you imagine? Alright. Warmonger. 2 of my arrows, 8 gold. Nothing good on a Charis, of course. Dibby dibby dibby. Doop doop dibby. What's this? Versus Lost Chest. 250 gold, 3 lockpicks, Staff of the Familiar. You know, I'm gonna skip that one. I like the way when you open this, you see the gears moving. It's like you can see how the chest works. It's interesting. Okay. Oh, is that a lift? Does it go down or up? What about all that? So I search that. Might be goodies down there. Don't know. That goes to abandoned cave. Does that go out? I'm just gonna look around. I'm gonna stop sneaking too, because we got a lot of ground to cover. Whatever comes at me, I'll try to handle it. Best to my ability, of course. I'd like to stay up here if possible. See if there's anything around here. Okay, I'm not seeing anything yet. Can I jump on this? Yeah. Alright. Oh, you scared the crap out of me. Don't do that. Dark. I gotta go back around. Could look around up there, but yeah, I'm not finding anything. Yeah, let's go up here. No, nothing. Okay. All right, let's check this out then. All aboard. All aboard the Great Lift. Come on. Let's sneak. Galea. There you go. Door bar. What about our stuff? Nothing's poisoned, okay. Well, this is our last frostbite venom. Do I have other poisons? Yeah, it's magicka and paralysis. Okay. That's how we actually dropped a little in weight, because we had so many frostbite venom. I didn't even realize I was carrying all that. Oh, this goes out. So we're done. Holy crap, guys, I finished Skyrim. I finished Skyrim. My god.
What was that?
It's a troll. It's our last troll. Well, we still got time left in this episode. Now, it's a quest item. I want to return this. I have no idea where to do it, so I'm going to cheat and look up where to put this fang thing. So, I will be right back. Okay, this Cavazane's fang thing has to do with the restoration ritual quest to get the ultimate restoration spell or spells. You have to get to 90 in restoration first, and I'm at 61, so maybe someday if I get there, you know, through playing something like a quest mod or something like that, I will get to restoration 90 and that will work. Then we can do that quest. Until then, I cannot. So, if there's anything I'm missing, just let me know. I will go around the map and so yeah, this is this area. So I got that. This is the west. No, sorry, the east coast. Here's the rift. So you guys can pause and see if there's anything I haven't discovered. That's over there, of course. Alright, so for some more. And then finally, here's the west. So there's that. Here's our quests. I didn't do these two quests, these don't fit with my character. And you have to I found them. But I found out at some point, I guess they said you have to sacrifice a follower. Yeah, that's not happening. And this you have to kill a priest. And this just goes on forever. They'll just keep giving you targets. This goes on forever. They'll just keep giving you things to hunt down in caves. This might have worked. I'm not sure. I'm not sure how it would work with the ultimate follower overhaul, so I didn't want to lose Carlia to be a follower for Delphine. That would really suck. And, I don't know, at some point when I killed some random dragon, it told me to return to Esbern. And all Esbern told me was to kill Parthenax, and I'm not killing Parthenax. And this, I'm not sure, either goes on forever, or I didn't find all the pendants. Either way, I mean, so what, I didn't find all the pendants. I explored all the locations in Solstheim. And, that I know. So, if I missed a pendant, it was because I just walked past it in one of those locations. Most probably. Those chests are pretty small. So I have to say, it's been one... whoa. Wild ride. Since the beginning. In, Helgen. With Alduin. And, I think I've grown a lot as a Let's Player since then. I think my commentary has gotten better. Possibly. I mean, it had been better even from that point, because I was already playing for about a year before I got to Skyrim. I started my, Let's Plays in the summer of 11. So, it's pretty exciting to be done with this game. Because I started it in April of 2012 and have been uploading daily videos since, who knows, since then. And I missed 2 weeks in the summer of 2012. I wasn't feeling well and I didn't have a lot of time to record. People were home constantly. And missing a day here and there. For because of YouTube problems, or because I wasn't feeling well, something like that, or because my internet service provider was down, or wanted money and I couldn't give it to them yet, something like that. So other than that, it's been daily videos, and I'll put well, I'm not done yet. I have a few more surprises for the next episode or two, apparently. So, I'm not completely done yet, but I know we're like 300 and over 310 hours, 590 something videos. That's insane for a Let's Play. That's crazy. So, a year and 10 months of playing, and I get to move on and do other things. So, my plans as far as, well, I plan on putting out a channel update, but what I plan on doing eventually, well, I'm going to go into another Let's Play, and after that is done, I'm going to play Falskar. So that's coming. That's going to be another daily Let's Play in this slot. And what I'm going to be doing over the weekends, I'm going to be playing we get to spin around now. I don't know if I want that to continue. Yeah. Skyrim quest mods, believe it or not. And what I plan, at least so far, is putting those up on the weekends. And I'm going to start with Moonpath to Elsewhere, of course, which is the first big quest mod that, you know, was released. So, I remember them reviewing that way back in January or February of 2012. So, they started working on that, I think, even before the creation kit came out. Correct me if I'm wrong. So, yeah, it's been one wild ride so far. Well, to the end. From the beginning to the end. A lot of content. A hell of a lot of content. And some people want me to, you know, play Daggerfall, Morrowind, Oblivion. They've been asking for everything except Arena. I'm a little hesitant right now to jump into another Elder Scrolls game, just because it's taken me 2 years to play this one, and I'd rather, you know, diversify myself a little bit and play some other things. But I do plan on playing some more Elder Scrolls. I'm divided between doing what I want to do, starting with Arena, and then going Daggerfall, Morrowind, Oblivion, and doing what other people want me to play, which seems to be Morrowind. mostly Morrowind. With one or two people asking for Oblivion or Daggerfall. So I'm kind of torn between Arena and Morrowind. Arena is okay because most of it's procedurally based, generated, so I'm not going to do endless questing, you know, get this book, get this necklace, etc. I mean, for experience, yeah, I could do that off screen, but that would be boring to watch. So I think what basically be doing is for Arena, watching me go through the cities and talking to different people, maybe doing some of those, a bunch of those dynamic quests off screen, and then going through the dungeons and getting the assorted pieces of the Staff of Chaos. So I don't know if there's any, you know, I'm looking, basically looking in that game for, well, what is unique content, you know, and what is procedurally generated. So I'll be staying away from the procedurally generated stuff, which seems to be a big portion of the game. So that, in light of that, Arena probably won't take too long to play. It's not going to be 200-300 hours. And from what I hear, Daggerfall is the longest game of all of them. I'm willing to play it, though, although I heard it's riddled with bugs. And Morrowind is pretty long, too. I've heard longer than Skyrim, because you there's a lot more running. You know, you can take transports to and from places, but you're kind of limited with that. You can't just, you know, bring up an auto map and just click on where you want to go. It doesn't work that way. You have to get to a major city, and then that Silt Strider will bring you to another major city, and from there you have to go find your way and survive things, which isn't always easy. So and then there's Oblivion, which, is, of course, is really long also. So I hope you guys can understand that I'm a little hesitant right now to jump into another 2 years of a game. I am going to be starting another RPG franchise, and it won't take me too long to get through that one, from what I hear. And when that is done, I will look and see where I want to go, because I do want to play. I am interested in The Witcher, especially given the, if you guys have seen the trailer to The Witcher 3. Yeah. I'm interested in playing 1 and 2 now, just to get to 3. Because I like to do that. I like to start, you know, I like to start at the beginning and work my way. It's kind of when I want to start with Arena. And I'm interested in Dragon Age also. I know they're working on the third one. I heard the second one stunk, but I'm willing to play through it anyway, you know. I'm sure it'll be interesting to play. It's just going to be, some parts will be unsatisfying, but it'll still be interesting to play, I'm sure. So that's it. This is not the last episode. We have another episode or two to go. So, I guess I'll, after that I'll have another little speech. So thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. Tune in the next episode. Little surprise I have in store. Nothing to get excited over. Just, you know, to be a completionist. I'm going to be playing through another aspect of Skyrim. You guys can probably guess what it is, I guess. So, long-time watchers can guess what I'm going to be running through. So, see you next time, and this is Nordpudding.